That's cool, though. I like it. STEM needs to grow, especially amongst women.
Yes.
We've got one right here. You studied STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math.
Yes.
And I'm glad you did, because I sure couldn't.
Same.
That was hard. It is. But it's great, and you don't have to do meteorology. I mean, there's so many fields if you study STEM subjects that you can get into. So.
That's right. My brother's a computer programmer,
okay.
And he is seeing an increased amount of women working in his office.
Oh, great.
Started off with very few, so it is evolving, changing. For the better.
Yeah.
It's exciting.
What about our forecast? How about that?
Yeah, it is evolving.
But not for the better necessarily.
It depends on what you like. If you're a fan of the heat, really going to like this. But if not, maybe not so much. Temperatures are getting back into the 90s starting tomorrow. We just need to get through one more day with a few lingering showers. And all that rain that was on the eastern side of the state has now moved on. And we are completely dry throughout Wayne County down into Fayette County. There are a few spotty showers still tracking through the state. We're going to keep that around, especially through the afternoon. But just an isolated shower, as far as that severe threat goes, that is down for today. And as far as the widespread rain, also not forecasting that either. So we are back into the lower 80s. Just know it is going to be just a touch cooler today, being held down because of this cloud cover and the fact that we're going to have that cold front come through. Winds pick up out of the west. And it will be a little breezy. A 25-mile-per-hour wind gust, not out of the question through the afternoon. Again, forecasting your high to reach 82. Future track 13 brings in mainly dry conditions through around lunchtime today. It's as we get into the afternoon and we heat everything back up, we might see one of these stray showers initiating, but most of us stay dry through the afternoon, going with around a 30% chance of rain for your afternoon, and then clearing out through the evening and overnight tonight. And then the heat comes. Tomorrow, everything's about to change. We're back up to 90 for a forecast high. The average for this time of year, still 84. So we're going to be above normal into your Thursday. Some of us into the lower 90s. And keep in mind, it's going to feel a lot different as well. We bring in a tropical air mass. So the air temperature's in the 90s, but it's going to feel more like the 100s. And that's a really big change here because the composition of the atmosphere around us is different. It's going to be harder to sweat, cool our bodies off. So we have to kind of readjust to the fact that the air around us is going to be a lot hotter, feeling more like 103 both Friday and Saturday. And these are going to be the two most oppressive days with this heat wave that will impact central Indiana. 94 to wrap up your work week, 95 on Saturday. Looking at it Sunday, though, we do have our next weather system. It's going to be a frontal boundary that comes through during the second part of the day on Sunday. That increases our rain chances, and it'll also hinder the temperatures just a bit, around 92 degrees to wrap up the weekend. Things to keep in mind if you have outdoor plans, Friday or Saturday especially, the hottest part of the day is between about 10 a.m. and 4 p.m., so we'll want to avoid being outside if at all possible. Give yourself time to take breaks, come into the air conditioning, get into the shade, and that's also something to note. These are temps in the shade. If you're going to be out in the sun at all, it's going to easily feel about 15 degrees warmer. Again, on Sunday, rain chance contained to mainly after 2 p.m., going with a 40% chance of those scattered showers. Might even see some storms as well. We start next week, and it does not look like we have a break from this heat as daytime highs remain in the lower 90s above average through next Tuesday.